This world is out of...
Your friend, are you ready to get started? Excellent.
Now it's not that sensitive. I don't understand.
The Black Whirlwind returns to the ring to face the Serpent. Might meets magic.
Thank you.
The Black Whirlwind returns to the ring to face the Serpent! Might meets magic!
Yeah!
The Black Whirlwind returns to the ring to face the Serpent! Might meets magic!
I know it's anticlimactic, but you did earn it. Congratulations, champion. I wish that I had another dozen fighters who could rise through the ranks with your electricity. I will not dishonor you with a pairing to those who cannot match your skill. In time, someone will come along, but I suspect your equal will not be manifesting anytime soon. Champion, it has been an honor to adjudicate and facilitate your rise to the top. Should anyone appear to challenge you, I will let you know. But until then, rest yourself. You've earned it.
It would be hard to find anyone in this city who does not recognize our new champion on this day. We have met before, but right now, I represent the Guild. Very well. The Guild suggests a truce. We had to address the issue of Kai Lan sooner or later. His open policy did not fit well with our philosophy of discretion. His power ran deep. He would have taken our organization even further down Gao the Greater's path had word of a new contestant not reached us. Every action benefits someone other than yourself. If you worry about whom, then you fall into inactivity. There are those who think and those who do. The best know that there is a time and place for both, and that this city will eat the introspective alive. It is advice we all need. Not speaking to me could aid them as easily. All waters flow to the ocean, they say. Indeed. Then you will be happy to know of the Guild's decision. We no longer want a stake in the proceedings in the arena. With Kai Lan and Gao the Greater gone, let us just say that cooler heads prevail. The current sentiment in the Guild is that the Lotus Assassins have become more trouble than our alliance with them is worth. Thus, we propose a truce. Your feud, or whatever it was, with Kai Lan died with him. The Guild will not trouble you or this place if you will not trouble us. Our business is concluded. If you will excuse a moment's adoration, it was an honor to meet you. Already some of the Guild have tried to emulate your styles. So effective are the blows of Tiger Lifts the Mountain. You should be proud. We will not speak of this again. Consider me nothing more than Sweet Poison Lin from this point on.
While I cannot see you, your appearance... What can I...
You must go to the Lotus Assassin Fortress like we agreed. Find the evidence against Death's Hand and I will help you rescue Master... Your progress is admirable, but don't become too close to the Lotus Assassins. Their power is seductive. That is how Death's Hand gain influence. After the disappearance of my uncle, Sun Kin, the Hand of Heaven, the Imperial Order of the Lotus Monks was directionless. Instead of taking on that role himself, my father gave it to an advisor, Death's Hand. I was only a baby at the time. He did not have enough time. The burden of state is heavy, and he is not a well man. Death's Hand takes advantage of this. Regardless, the Lotus Monks were placed in the care of Death's Hand, a duty reserved for royalty. It was almost as if my father took Death's Hand into our family, my family. We have been caretakers of the Empire for generations. We have created a bastion of culture in an otherwise uncivilized world. Death's Hand threatens all of this. It is my duty to see that the natural order is preserved. About me? But why? I mean, there's so much I've told you already. I really don't think that we need any more information to complete our mission. Well, I suppose I could answer a few questions. Although I'm sure more than enough has been said about me by the peasants or others, I am quite used to defending myself from all quarters. Harsh times demand harsh actions. This is a time of trial for my family and the Empire, one I shall not fail. I hope they do not only speak of my harshness despite my position above them. We all want people to speak well of us. You presume a great deal. Can you really have seen this in such a short time? Those are qualities I would like to say I have, but I am not certain that I do. I have little time for listening when I seem to be fighting the very system of which I am a part. You? Well, you might. I don't know what the future will bring for us, Do you think yourself worthy of reminding me of what is important? To keep me humble? My father will take a dim view of that. Wait, this is further than I thought this conversation would go. This is not proper. I will not allow it. You presume too much. I think we have had quite enough amusement for now. But do not hesitate.
Champion, it has been an honor to adjudicate and facilitate your rise to the top. Should anyone appear...
Nara'ir uk napir.
Not much to do at the top. No. Your skills would just waste away with no challenges. I wonder if it'll be me, the Sung brothers, or some other upstart who brings you down.
I knew you could do it! Congratulations, champion.
You have our collective congratulations, champion. You have done great things in this place.
I don't want to talk to you. I had a good thing going with the Serpent. He paid a handsome fee, but he never trusted me enough to make use of my services. Now that's all gone.
Don't stare at me. I'm not here for your amusement.
What do you... Magical and...
Get out of my kitchen.
Sisayiri furk to asayir napsan. Gir uksayirnan. Bobo Irek, Tintuno, Waka. Kupfukno I Nayaf, the year, Sawa, you know. Sayir on Nikufunir, Aknat near Sawir Pika. Pay year soon. Oh, now a year, soon punao, Boko Nar, Yo year, Oto now a year, Sada, Okikir, Kikir, Usair, no soon. Nano wo, nawaf tata sini here, uk uno.
You return once again to interrupt lustful Lao, master. Always, I say.
I regret I have no more missions for you, but I'm all...
You must go to the Lotus Assassin Fortress like...
Yes? How can this humble bunmaster assist you today? I still can't believe it's that easy to become a Lotus Assassin. If I had known sooner, I would have joined their ranks as soon as possible. It would be brutal work, with little reward, and there's a good chance I'd die a hideous, painful death. But it couldn't all be better than married life, could it? Like many things in my life, it can be traced back to very bad luck on my part. As I mentioned once before, I was a master of the Drunken Master style. I was the tournament champion in Phoenix Gate when things spun out of control. My need for wine took its toll on my body. There are long periods I don't even remember. After one such period, I came to, having lost most of my clothes and all my money. I was destitute, and without the ability to buy more wine, I couldn't even fight. Eventually, I found work cleaning out creature cages at the local arena. One day, I was approached by a man who remembered seeing me fight. He offered to sponsor me. Just like that, I was back in the ring. After climbing my way back to the top of the tournament, my sponsor told me it was time to fulfill my end of the bargain. Apparently, the agreement stipulated that I must marry his niece. If only I had read the agreement more closely, I could still be shoveling dirt in the creature cages. Alas, fate had a crueler path in mind for me. Let that be a lesson for you. Always read the fine print, or you may end up with more than you bargained for. You're beginning to sound like my wife. Where were you last night? Why were you talking to that woman? Why do you smell like a goat? Always with the questions. As I mentioned earlier, after becoming tournament champion for the second time, I was forced to marry my sponsor's nubile niece. She is the reason I no longer fight. My disapproving dove did not care for my drinking, or for my friends, or my fighting, or my friends' fighting. She believed I should settle down, be more respectable. At first I ignored her rebukes and continued fighting, but I soon learned that she was not a woman to be crossed. Prior to one fight, my duplicitous Daisy drugged my wine. I don't remember much of what happened next, which is fortunate. From what I hear, it wasn't very pretty. I spent the next several months under the tender ministrations of my doting wife. Needless to say, when I was well enough to walk again, I was more than happy to settle down. As to why I became a bondmaster, well, it's a hard, thankless job that keeps me very, very busy. Very busy. Asking the same question over and over and expecting a different answer. That is the definition of a pestering and overbearing wife. Please try to stop reminding me of my missing missus. It is a memory too painful to bear. My prescient pretty has an uncanny knack for derailing my plans, in case you haven't already noticed. I have tried several times to leave. Some say there are spirits out there that masquerade as people, and I suspect she may be one of them. She has my soul. One time, I tried to sneak away while she was delivering a special order of buns to her uncle's family. As I started to leave, I slipped on some oil and broke my arm. Still, I put my arm in a sling and was continuing on my way when I was run down by a rogue bun cart. When I came to, my wife had returned and was in a foul mood. Apparently, everyone she had visited died from food poisoning. But why not her? I mean, I'm sure she ate at least one of the buns I sent. It is simply my lot in life to be given into the care of a demon whose sole sustenance comes from sucking the very life from my body and soul. Soup, anyone? As you...
Always happy to help. What do you need? Of course. I'll be here if you need anything.
Always.
You managed to satisfy the Lotus Assassin. Despite my misgivings, I can't help but smile at the thought that you're the reason they're so keen to acquire new recruits. Nothing like thinning the ranks to make some room. Dawnstar has been telling me about two rivers, the Swamp and Gao the Lesser. I was sorry to hear about your town and your friends. It brought a question to mind. There's something I've been meaning to ask you. Why? Seriously, why are you doing this? Details aside, you're fighting the Empire as a whole when you oppose the Lotus Assassins, Death's Hand, or the Emperor's will. I know all about your village and your master, and that explains some of it. What it doesn't explain is your drive, your strength. What gives you that? I wonder if fate cast this burden upon you, or if you rose up on your own to shoulder it. History will probably decide. I know you're going to follow Silk Fox's plans to find a way into the Assassin's Den. It's what happens after you find a way in that has me worried. I knew men and women who were drawn to the Lotus Assassins. They went into that place to prove themselves, as you intend to. And the few who made it back out were different. They acted like they didn't know us, or just didn't care if we lived or died. It's hard to say if there's even a difference to the Lotus Assassins. I know you'll be fine. The Assassins will be lucky if you don't bring the place down around their ears. Just be sure not to tip your hand before you're ready. That's all in the future, though. We should keep it what we're doing.
What? I remember one time I was hired by two warring clans. They were going to discuss a peace treaty, and they wanted me to make sure things didn't get out of hand. A bunch of fights broke out in the first few days, but after I killed a few dozen of their clansmen, they settled down. That's when things got boring. The leaders took the next 3 days to talk and talk, and if they hadn't let me dip into their wine stocks, I might have snapped sooner than I did. The clan leaders were agreed on peace, except for one thing, Jin Lo, a beautiful clanswoman. Both leaders wanted her, and neither would give her up. After 5 days, it looked like the peace would fall apart. It looked like the two leaders were about to come to blows over Jin Lo, so I stepped in. It was my job to stop them from fighting. So, I cleaved the wench in two and told them each to take a half. Seemed like a good idea at the time. They weren't too happy with my decision. Everyone turned on me. Of course, they all died, but they gave it a good effort. I don't know what they were so upset about. Better a quick death by the sword than the prolonged agony of your heart being ripped from your chest and thrown to the dog. This is going to be You know, battles like this don't come along every day. We could very well die in there, cut up into small pieces, trying to fight. I'm getting goosebumps just... Too much talking and thinking. I was supposed to make sure the pests stayed out of the sacred pools, but hunting rats one at a time is boring work. So I had an idea, a way to catch them all at once. I convinced the monks to give me some of their sacred wine, and I filled the sacred pools. I figured if I could get the rats drunk, they'd be so much easier to catch. Nothing happened at first, so I helped myself to the wine. I passed out before the rats came. In the middle of the night, I was woken up by screaming monks and fiery explosions. It was just the rats. The poor furry buggers were just trying to get warm near the monks' fires after their swim in the wine. Not a good combination. The monks wanted me gone. I might have deserved the blame, but the abbot insisted it was a sign from the gods and closed the monastery. See what happens when you think too much? What? What? Tried that once, and it didn't work out. Prefect Mu Hong pledged his daughter Mi Shan to me after I cleared his district of bandits. She wasn't ugly, so I agreed. The night of the wedding feast, I got more than a little drunk, and in the morning I woke up in the prefect's bed, next to the prefect's wife. I got up and went into my bride's room, and there was a strange man in her bed. I killed the bastard and was about to kill her when Mi Shan came into the room yelling. Apparently, I had just killed her sister's husband and was about to kill her sister. I tried to tell her it was an honest mistake, but she wouldn't hear it. The brother-in-law's family was pissed, and so was the prefect when he found out about his wife. They tried to subdue me, so they could send me to prison. I killed them all swiftly. None of them suffered. Still, Mi Shan wouldn't leave with me. She kept crying and complaining about her family. Family life just isn't for me. I'm a fighter, not a damn history book. No more.
Well, well, is the Imperial City all you expected? It is quite a spectacle compared to the bulk of the Empire. The marvelous dragonfly performed perfectly, of course. I found my way to Tien's Landing quite by accident. A very big accident. A few wealthy merchants lost some, property, and I almost lost my hat and my head. Gao the Greater heard about my inventions and bribed some officials to effect my release. I thought I had found a nice rich benefactor, but I was locked away in his lair. He gave me a nice workshop, but he really was a fool. I showed him my wind map. He didn't care where it led. He was only interested in his slaves. It shows where I've been, not where I'm going, I think. I made it on my journey to, here. But I don't quite remember where I was traveling from. Not good. It seems to me I left something, a clue for myself. But I'm not sure why I'd need to. I don't suppose you'd be interested in taking a short trip back the way I came? Well, let's see then. It must lead to... Keep an eye out. I don't know why my tracks were covered, but I do tend to incur...
This
This looks familiar. Keep going. I have the urge to build something. There are memories in the route we are flying. Keep going. I see patterns, schematics. Keep going. I'll hammer it out. Almost there. Just a few more pieces to figure out. Our flight was great fun. Lots of explosions. But what does it mean? One thing for certain, there was no destination. We ended where we began. The route was the important part. Let me show you. I'm not sure what it is. Hill and nothing. Right? We're not dead, I think. I need some time to think, to get my brain straightened out. This is most intriguing. I've given some thought to the strange device that I was inspired to construct. I'm not sure what purpose it has yet, but it appears to be working, I think. Just a few tweaks. Tight fit. Not sure how that will affect things. What's it? I don't remember seeing that before. Just get this last. There we go. It's ready. Now we can finally find out just what it does. After I name it, of course. Nothing works right until you name it. How about the confoundable minutia? What? No, impossible! I fixed it! Oh, where'd the city go? Well, that was anticlimactic. A flash of light, but no resounding boom. What good is such a light if Earth doesn't meet sky? What? Oh my. It seems we have transported to a heaven. A strangely familiar one for some reason, but I don't recall ever moving to such a place before.
Where have you brought us, Kang? We don't have time for such games. Get us back to the Imperial City, now!
Good idea. Something about this place makes me want to explore too. I am compelled to step this way. There are gears here that I remember.
Kang, return at once! Kang! Ugh, let's go find him.
Look at this. It's a marvel. A wonder of monumental proportions. A phenomenal piece of I haven't the slightest idea. But it must... These machines, they are manipulators, fabricators. They bully energy into something. They can be activated, I can only come to one conclusion. Lord Lao's furnace.
Lord Lao, he's a story for children, like how he created the air bladders that lifted the palace until the stones forgot they belonged to the earth.
Legendary. mythical, and overrated in some respects, but if anyone else has a better origin for such machines as this, I'm not hearing it. Artificer to the celestial bureaucracy, he creates machines that themselves also create. Although I'd make them a little less delicate had I his resources. Still, he is an inspirational figure for inventors, and we are in his playhouse. You select the machines you want to activate, and then the tiger or the dragon button, like this. Don't worry. The individual machines are not activated. I think the switches must be thrown on at least two of the components before it will do whatever it does. You also have to select a fuel. It looks like there are a few pieces of cinnabar in the contraption, but it may Well, judging by the pile of ashes I found near the controls, if you do it wrong, it either creates a nice warm fire or burns the person standing here to a crisp. It looks like a powerful thing, so just guessing at the possible configurations will... So, you might want to be careful how you go about it. Things like this usually have directions. Recipes. No, that's not it. Configurations. That's it. Very true. Perhaps you...
to buy everything.